Thank you for joining me for Beginner's Guide to Wire Wrapping Tumble Stones Part 2. In this video I am going to show you some simple ideas for turning our basic wraps into pendants, hopefully kickstarting your own amazing creations. In the next video I will demonstrate some more complex designs and techniques to boost your creativity. I am going to start with a really quick and easy design using a snowflake obsidian wrapped with 3 base wires. I am going to start by creating the bale using the back 2 wires. I am using this small screwdriver as a mandrel to help shape the bale. I bend the back 2 wires over the mandrel. I bring the bottom securing wire from the front to secure the bale wires, wrapping around a couple of times. I slightly separate the bale loops and trim the excess wire. Using round nose pliers, I am forming a small loop to make the raw end safe. Trim the excess from the securing wires. With the final 2 wires, I am going to form simple spirals. I trim the excess and, using round nose pliers, start to create a loop at the ends. Before the loop is complete, I trim off a small amount at the end and then continue to form the loop and start the spiral. I switch to flat nose pliers to keep the spirals flat. Maneuver the spirals to cover the securing wires. We are now going from minimum to maximum with this tangerine aura quartz wrapped with 5 base wires. I have already trimmed the excess from the securing wires and I am starting on the bale using the 2 back wires. I am using 0.4mm wire, that's 27 gauge, to wrap around the 2 back wires. I am simply wrapping the 2 wires together until I have enough length for the bale, approximately 2 centimeters or 1 inch. When I have wrapped far enough, I finish by bringing the 0.4mm wire down between the 2 base wires, wrapping once around each wire individually and trimming the excess. Separate the 2 unwrapped ends and shape your bale around a mandrel, bringing the ends to the front. The ends are trimmed and spiraled. Do not discard any of the wire that is trimmed off. They can be used to make chains for our pendants. I will demonstrate in another video. Maneuver the spirals to cover the securing wire. Next, I am going to take the foremost wire and create an organic swirl. following the same swirl with the next two wires and bringing them around the back of the pendant. With the remaining three wires, I am following the first part of the swirl and bringing the wires around the back to meet the others. With the top four wires, I am bringing them around to the front and adding more spirals. The last two wires will remain at the back. I do not want to just leave them loose as they may get caught in clothing, so I am attaching them to the frame wire using 0.2mm wire and then trimming and looping the ends. The next design will be using this rough fuchsite wrapped with three base wires. A note of caution when using unpolished stones. When you run your finger across the stone and see rock dust come off the stone, you will need to seal it as no one wants to breathe any stone dust. This stone has had a couple of coats of clear varnish. I am going to start with the securing wires and we are going to make a rose. Keeping the wires flat, start to spiral the wires around each other, going in the same direction. Lift the leading wire and allow the trailing wire to go underneath the first. Continuing around, lift the leading wire again and allow the trailing wire to go underneath again. Keeping your thumb on the top will help to keep the rose flat. Continue the pattern until your rose is big enough. Trim the excess wire and tuck the ends underneath the rose. I'm going to make the bail the same as the last design, using the back two wires. Again, we are going to bring the wire under the bail wires to the front, and we are going to use these wires to make another rose. The ends are being a little stubborn, tucking underneath, so I am gently using flat nose pliers to help get that nice round shape. I am taking one of the top wires and gently curving it over the front of the pendant and attaching to the frame wire using 0.2mm wire. I am now following the shape of the first wire with the other top wire, leaving a gap between the two as I will be adding beads. These beads are antique copper effect metal beads to match the wire once it has been aged and polished. Once I have enough beads, I am weaving it to the first wire and frame. I am finishing the pendant by weaving and curving the two wires into a pleasing design and attaching to the frame on the other side. The final design for this video will be using this dyed clear quartz palm stone. This stone has been wrapped with three base wires and I've used an extra wire to secure the frame to leave more wires available for the design. I want to use these two antique bronze effect charms in the design. They will be attached to the securing wires. I make a small loop in the wire and add the charm. It should sit at the bottom of the loop. I then wrap the remaining wire around the other wires to secure the charm. I repeat with the other wire and charm. trim the excess wire. Using the two back wires, I am now creating the bail and bringing the ends to the front. I am going to use the ends of the bail wires to hide where the charms are attached. I could use spirals, but since this is a nature theme, I will use a rose. I am going to curve the first of the top wires across the front of the pendant and follow with the second. Using 0.2mm wire, I start to weave them to the frame wire. With the third wire, I will follow the same curve, adding beads. The beads are antique bronze effect to match the charms. When I have enough beads, I weave the wire with the first two. The fourth wire simply follows the others and is added to the weave. I am weaving and bending the wires, trimming and looping the ends to make what I feel is a pleasing design. Just let your creativity take over. Here we have a few more items using the same techniques that I have demonstrated in this video. I hope you are feeling inspired to get creative. In the next video, I will be demonstrating some designs using more complex techniques. I hope you will join me. Thank you so much for watching.